الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we repent to Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And if anyone has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. I bear witness, there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, His servant and His messenger. O Allah, let Your prayer, Your peace and blessing be upon Your servant Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the series of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's ethics, we still with the ethic of al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, still with the verses of al-istighfar, and the Surah Al-Tahrim, verse 3, say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu tubu ilallahi tawbatan nasuha, Asa rabbukum an yakaffir ankum sayyatikum wa yadkhulukum jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhar, yawma la yukhzi Allahu an-nabiyya walladhina amanu ma'ah, nuruhum yas'a bayna aydihim, وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking the believers to seek repentance. That successful repentance, so may Allah will forgive all the sins. And may Allah will, when you say may Allah, this means that it's happening. And may Allah will take you to the paradise, where within the paradise is rivers flow. And that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not let down the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the believers, because their lights going to be within their hands and to their right and in front of them. And the believers, in the day of judgment, and even before they getting into the Surat al-Mustaqim, they will be known. The believers will be known because of the wudu. All the wudu that you make is going to make lights on you. You're going to be like walking lights. You will be recognized. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will not miss you. You are not going to be missed, because all the wudu that we make will put lights on you that you will be distinguished. Even the people, the disbelievers, will be trying to catch, because it's completely dark, except the people who, the believers who had this light through the wudu, the disbeliever will try to run behind you and catch you, but it will be a veil between you and them. So this is, when you make wudu, make sure that you make it as perfect as you can. Well, this wudu is going to, we will be walking lights in the day of judgment before you get into the Surat al-Mustaqim, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam will recognize you for that. You will be recognized. You will be known. So and yasa nuruhum yasa bayna aydihim wa baaymanihim. In your hands, right and left, in front of you will be lights. The believers and the Prophet will say, "Oh Allah, make our iman complete, and forgive us, and oh Allah, you are able to do all things." So this means that this is you, something that in your hands to enhance your goodness in the day of judgment. When you, whatever you do, make it good. When you make wudu, make good wudu. When you make salah, perform the salah as it should be. Do not just do it and go. No, pay attention to every word you say, and pay attention to every action you do. Seek the perfection of prayer as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed. By this way, you get the complete reward from that. Also, istighfar, you can make istighfar for yourself and make istighfar for somebody else. Istighfar could be for you and for somebody else. And in Surah Al-Imran, verse 159, look at this beautiful verse. All the verses are beautiful, of course, but look at this. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَا كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ فَاعْفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. Look at the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam merciful for us. He never been hard on us. He was and the companions too. So the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was just mercy. And the people, the companion loved him to the extent that they will die for him. Because of his merciful, because of his kindness, because of his all his morals and qualities. And because, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you are not merciful, if you are hard and hard-hearted on them, then they're going to be walking away from you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the Prophet the quality for the companions and for a Muslim to love him more than they love themselves. And at the same time, if the Prophet was tough and rough and hard on the believers, they will walk away from him. They are not going to listen to him. They are not going to surround him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the Prophet that qualities for the believers to love the Prophet to that extent. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to forgive the companions, to forgive them, fa'afu anhum, forgive them, forbade them, and wastaghfir lahum, and seek forgiveness for them. Even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make istighfar for his ummah to the extent that one time he was making istighfar. Aisha asked him to make istighfar for her. He made istighfar for her. And he was laughing. And then why you are laughing? I asked him why you are laughing. Because I am saying this to every person in my nation, every Muslim, that he making istighfar for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making istighfar for us all the time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Prophet to do that. فَعَفُ عَنْهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ. This is fa'afu anhum, forgive them, and seek forgiveness for them, or supplicate, seek forgiveness from them. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ, and take their opinions in the matters. When you decide it, then go ahead. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love al-mutawakkilin. فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ, make all your affairs in the hands of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love that. And also in Surah Nisa, verse 64, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا لِيُطَاعَ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا اللَّهَ وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولِ لَوَجَدُوا اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, whenever they send the Prophet, so they should be obeyed, because the Prophet is coming with commandments from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if the believers do something wrong, they come to you, جَاءُوكَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُ اللَّهِ, they come to you, so they seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also the Prophet will make istighfar for them, and they will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. لَوَجَدُوا اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا, they will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most merciful, the most forgiving for them. So that's all what you do, seek forgiveness, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to punish us as long as we make istighfar. It was two conditions. It was the time of the Prophet when he was alive, and the continuous making istighfar. So making istighfar, that will hold any punishment on us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this means that your tongue should be all the time making istighfar non-stop. Non-stop. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Ladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh. Make that istighfar all the time, because this is going to remove your sins. You're going to get rewarded, because when you make istighfar, the angels will make istighfar in your istighfar. Then you good, and when you make istighfar, also make istighfar for yourself, for your family, for the believers, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for with the numbers of believers that you make istighfar for. And also in Surah Yusuf, قال رب اغفر لي ولأخي وادخلنا في رحمتك وأنت أرحم الراحمين. إن الذين اتخذوا العجل سينالهم غضب من ربهم وذلة في الحياة الدنيا وكذلك نجزي المفترين. والذين عملوا السيئات ثم تابوا من بعدها وآمنوا إن ربك من بعدها لغفور رحيم. Now, this is on the tongue of Prophet Musa عليه السلام, when he said, رب اغفر لي ولأخي وادخلنا في رحمتك وأنت أرحم الراحمين. Sayyidina Musa was making istighfar for himself and for his brother Harun. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful, the most forgiving. And the people who took the calf as their God, which is the Bani Israel, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have punishment on them in this life and in the afterlife. وَالَّذِينَ عَمَلُوا السَّيَّئَاتِ ثُمَّ تَابُوا. But the people who made these sins and they made istighfar after that, وَآمَنُوا إِنَّ رَبَّكَ مِنْ بَعْدِهَا لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So the door of mercy, the door of forgiveness is open all the time until you're about to die. So don't leave a chance. As soon as you think that you made something, or even you made or you did not make any mistakes, always make istighfar. Because this istighfar is going to not only forgive your sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but also you will get rewards for that. You will get not only rewards, you will get financial privileges, you will get all kind of material and for material benefits this life and also in the afterlife. This is for Surah Yusuf. قال لا تثريب عليكم اليوم يغفر الله لكم وهو أرحم الراحمين. Now, Prophet Yusuf عليه السلام, when he met his brothers and they acknowledged the face to face, both of them, they acknowledged what mistake they made when they throw them in the well, and even after all what they did, but Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for their brothers who mistreated him and threw him in the well. They wanted to even to kill him. قال لا تثريب عليكم لا تثريب عليكم اليوم. It's no more anything wrong with you. Allah يغفر الله لكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. وهو أرحم الراحمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful and the most forgiven. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم أدعو الله عسى أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم, وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. In Surah Yusuf also verse 96 and 98, فلما جاء البشير ألقاه على وجهه فارتد بصيرا قال ألم أقل لكم إني أعلم من الله ما لا تعلمون. قالوا يا أبانا استغفر لنا ذنوبنا إن كنا خاطئين. قال سوف أستغفر لكم ربي إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Now this is still with the story of Prophet Yusuf عليه السلام, when the person who came with the clothes of Prophet Yusuf and he threw it on the face or in the eyes of his father Yaqub. and he became he was able to see after that. And the Prophet Yaqub told his sons, "Didn't I tell you that I know from Allah that you don't know?" So they admitted now the mistake that they did. They admitted that they threw their brother in the well, and now they asking their father to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for what they have done wrong. And they said that we were wrongdoing. We were wrongdoer. We did wrong when we did that. قَالَ سَوْفَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ. I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most merciful. This means that when somebody asks you for forgiveness if they did something wrong, do not reject that. Forgive the person who made wrong to you, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for him, because this is going to be add more rewards for you. So if somebody made a mistake and say, "No, I'm not going to forgive you," no, don't say that, because examples of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering the person always to forgive the people who made mistakes to you, that when the person who talking bad about Aisha radiallahu anha, and he was a relative of Abu Bakr, and Abu Bakr was giving him money to live, he was supporting him. But when this happened, so Abu Bakr Siddiq said, "I'm not going to give him money anymore. I'm not going to support him anymore." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a specific verse told, "Don't you like that Allah will forgive you?" Specific direct communication from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Abu Bakr. "Oh Allah, yes, I would like you to forgive me." And he went back and he started giving the support for that person who made the mistake, and he went the saying about Aisha radiallahu anha. It means that when you forgive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you abundantly. So do not take it personal, because when you take it personal, you punish yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you if you forgive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more and more if you forgive the person who made mistakes to you. So keep that in mind, and don't. And the person who will not forgive, this is a bad quality of a Muslim. This is something that you keep in blessings coming to you. You keep in good things in coming to you. So you're rejecting things good for you because of you blocking that forgiveness for that person. So always keep that in mind, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you abundantly when you forgive others for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And especially if you are strong enough to do that. When you're strong enough, when you are able to do that, then your rewards will be even more and more. Look at this beautiful supplication here. That's in Surah Ibrahim, verse 40 and 41. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِنْ ذُرِيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابِ. You know, these two verses here, you should keep it by heart and say it all the time. All the time, because in the day and night and after the prayer, because see, رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِيَّتِي رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءَ. Oh Allah, made me perform the prayers and my inherit, my people that come after me, my children and my offspring. Oh Allah, accept the prayer. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي. Oh Allah, forgive me. And forgive my parents, والدي, and forgive all the believers. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابِ. In the day of resurrection. You standing and you asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, to forgive your parents, and to forgive all the believers in the day of judgment. Could you imagine in the day of judgment, you asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all the believers? And this is not going to be just for yourself. No. You're going to get forgiveness for yourself, and you're going to get rewards with the numbers of the believers, all the believers that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for them, you're going to get rewards for that. So don't keep yourself just for yourself. No, be open to others, to open to the other believers, because this is something good for you. And when you repeat, when you repeat this prayer, رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. This is going to help you to perform your prayer. It should be, because you ask Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to help you to perform your prayer correctly. And Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, when you ask Him for that, He will give it to you. And it will give not only for you, but for your everybody around you, your children, and everybody from you. There's many, as I mentioned before, there's many of these beautiful verses about the istighfar. And inshallah, we'll continue on in a future khutbah about all these beautiful verses and also the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam too. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. O Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart, and spirit. O Allah, do not let our hearts deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer, and of my descendants, our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents, and all the believers until the day of resurrections. Glory to Allah, Lord of Majesty and Honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي للصلاة حي للفلاة كاتب الصلاة كاتب الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيم وارحمكم الله. الله أكبر
الله أكبر
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إلى في قريش إلى فيهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وأمنهم من خوف. الله أكبر
الله أكبر
صلى الله عليه وسلم
ربنا لك الحمد. Allahu Akbar.
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 الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إلهاف قريش إلهافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. الله أكبر
الله أكبر ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أستغفر الله. أستغفر الله. أستغفر الله.